The next time you're at an Orange County intersection, look around. Your eyes may land on a surprising piece of art. All new at 6, WESH 2's Amanda Ober has more on a quickly expanding program that's helping to win the war against graffiti.
This is a traffic engineering utility box, and it's a common target for graffiti, especially so-called tags like that one. Now, the city of Orlando has come up with a unique plan to combat the graffiti and turn this into a work of art.
Orlando City Commissioner Patty Sheehan is painting a portrait of her cat on a traffic engineering box near the intersection of Virginia Ave and Fern Creek. It's titled Bad Kitty.
Louis Armstrong, my bad kitty, has been my inspiration for this piece, and he's a little crazy.
When she's done, her painting will look like this. Sheehan competed for a chance to be one of dozens of local artists who are turning utility boxes into works of art.
We like to think that we've created public art that can be enjoyed by the residents, the businesses, anyone just driving up and down the streets.
Joanne Grant is the director of Mills 50, a neighborhood organization which has overseen the painting competition. So far, 15 boxes have been painted, including this one done by second graders at Fern Creek Elementary. The program started as a way to combat graffiti. All of the artwork is sealed with a graffiti-resistant coating, but it may not be needed. Over the past year, only one of the painted boxes has been defaced.
There's like an unwritten rule that you don't mark on someone else's work. So they're very respectful. Taggers, graffiti artists, are respectful of these art boxes.
The program is catching on. This week, the Orlando City Council approved its expansion to Audubon Park, College Park, and Downtown South. Artists interested in competing to paint one of the 5 remaining boxes in the Mills Colonial District can apply on the Mills 50 website.
The artists who are chosen to paint these boxes will be provided with up to $100 worth of paint and materials. In Orlando, Amanda Ober, WESH 2 News.